guys, welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial I'm going to show you guys how to create a simple contact form. So by the end of this tutorial you will know how to create something like this simple contact form. It's really looking interesting, so stay tuned and let's get into it. As you can see, I have my HTML file open up here, just simple one, and then I also have my CSS file open up here. There's no code yet. I link it to my HTML. If you don't know how to link your CSS file to your HTML, I did a video about this before, so I will leave the link in the description below. Sorry, so you can check it out. But yeah, on today's video, I will show you guys how to create a contact form in HTML with only HTML and CSS. So, without being said, let's get into it. Okay, first, what I will do is I will create a div. I always like to create a div first. Opening and closing, and then this div I will give it a class name. I'll give it a class name of, let's say, contact form. The reason I like to create a div first, I will tell you about this later on, but for now just stay with me. So, and then now I'll create a form. I'll come up with a form tag. In HTML we've got a form tag, form, open and close it. Sorry, open and close it, and then now like that, opening tag and then closing tag of a form. And then in here I will, let's say, want to create a contact form, right? So let's give it a title, h1, a title like a contact form. So if you open this in your browser, here, just showing contact form. There's no form yet. So what I will do is, first I'll give it a label, opening and closing. A label. Let's say the name. Input, let's say the name, input, then we got the input, which is tag, the input which is the type is a text. Then if you come to your browser, you refresh, you will see there is an input, something like a form here where you can write something. So this one, you can tell that it's in the same line with our label, the name label, the input, and then the name is in. If you want to put it down here, you just have to come here. There are simpler way to do that is to just put a break here, a break tag here in front of your label. And then once you refresh, it's down now. So that's the most simpler way. There's the other way, but for now, just stick with that one. And then let's say we also want to create an input form for a surname. So what I did, I just copy this and then paste it in here. Give it a surname. Give it a surname, and same thing for, let's say, email, and then when we come to the message part, but I like to use something we call a text area. This setting here, we can I will explain this. This is just the name of the text area, and then the row, you want it to have 8 rows. You can adjust this maybe to 6 if you want to, 70 if you want to. Then this is the text area. So if you come here, refresh, you will see that you have this. Let's just this, put a bright thing as well on here. Put a bright tag. Put a bright tag on here. And bright tag on here. Then you can refresh. You see everything is lined up perfect. One thing I want to explain on here is this. With this, these are the row and the columns. So the reason I like to use a text area tag for the message is because with this text area, you can be, if you bring your cursor in, you can be able to adjust this. You see, you can adjust it. Unlike the input one, you can't adjust this, but then the text area, you can adjust it. Let's say you are writing a really long messages, so if it was this small, then if you go down, there's no way you can read that. So you can adjust this to however you want to. So let's move forward, and then we'll create a button. A button. Let's type. It's a button, and then the name, I like to call it the submit button. As you can see, if you refresh, there's the button. You can't see that. So the reason you can't see that, you can put a bright in here as well. The reason you can see that is this small here. This is your button, so you have to come in here and write at least submit. Write submit there, and then refresh. So your submit button is here. As you can see, this is just a pure HTML form with no CSS. So let's go ahead and add some CSS to it. First of all, let's call out our div, which is contact form. The contact form, we want to give it a width of let's say 50%. We want to position it, let's give it relative. I'm not gonna talk more about relative, like positioning. And then let's give it a background color. Let's say we want to keep it gray, and then we want to center it in the center of the center of our browser. Let's refresh this. As you can see, it's centered with a background color of gray. So let's say we want to move this a bit inside so that this there should be space here at the, on the edge there. So let's give our let's give it a padding of, let's say, 20 pixel, padding of 20 pixel. Refresh. As you can see, there is now space here. So let's call out our contact form H1, which is the heading, which is this heading here. We want to, let's say, we want to increase this one. We want to change the font size. Let's make it 30 pixel, and then we want to change the color. Let's make it gray. Oh no, let's make the color, let's say, brown. Let's say we want to make the color brown. We refresh. As you can see there, it's now brown. Now we come to the form. The form itself, which is the contact. Now the contact, and then form, and then form. You want to give it a background color of brown as well, with a padding of 10 pixel. Let's see now. Background color is brown. Background color is brown with a padding here. If you remove this padding, you will see that your texts are on the edge. If you remove that padding, you will see that your texts are on the edge here. So you add a padding to make sure that it's spaced in. And then the reason, like I said at the beginning, I will explain why I decided to create a div here. It's because of this. Let's say you are creating a website with a lot of forms, so you have to give your form a specific unique name so that when you call it in CSS, the settings, whatever code you write in there, it will only apply to that one form. You know what I'm saying? To that one form. So it doesn't have to apply to all the forms that are in your page. But if you only got one form on your page, then you don't have to call the div. You can just create something like that and then call it a form. And then the code that will still apply. The code will still apply. You can see you refresh, the code is just because you only got one form on your page. But if you got multiple, try to give it a unique names. Okay, let's move forward to turn. Now let's change the size of this input. To do that, we call it contact form input. We want to give it a width of, let's say, 100 pixel, with a height of 10 pixel, and a padding of 2 pixel. Let's see how what that changes. As you can see, this input with the height contact form input, you principles, and you can just play around with code just to see how it will fit. Let's also give it a margin, on top to move it. Let's give it like 10 pixels. As you can see here, it's too close to the label, to the text, so let's move it a bit down. As you can see, let's also give it a margin. Margin at the bottom of 10 pixels. As you can see here, 10 pixels. Then remove this, make it look a bit nicer. Make it just 2 pixels on top. Then you will see that like that. Then you come to contact form. Contact form text area, the width 90%. To align it the same way. Let's make it, let's make them all 95% to align them perfectly. And then let's change the padding of the form to 20. Okay, perfect. Then let's change the margin. Let's go to the button. You see it's like that, but let's move it a bit down. So to do that, we give it a margin, at the top to 10 pixels. Want to move it a bit down, 10 pixels, it's not a bit down. So let's just change the color of this to maybe back to white or something. The color not brown, but let's make them white or something like that. Yeah, the form. So that's your form. Let's just move this form a bit down, so it doesn't have to be at the top there. To do that, you can change this. You come to the form itself, to the div itself, and then margin top. Let's give it like 30 pixel. You want to move it a bit down. And then refresh. It's down. So let's increase that to maybe 60. As you can see, it's now in the middle. So you can choose it. As you can see, you can write some code here. We can see change, increase the label size. Let's just increase the contact. Contact form. A label. see it's not a bit bigger, and then change font size to 20 pixels. You can font weight to bold them, font weight, if you want to bold them, you can hit that say bold. As you can see, but if it's bold, it is not looking good, so let's remove that. Now we got your nice and simple contact form. Simple and nice contact form for you. So yeah, that's how you create a simple contact form. Make sure you hit the like button and subscribe. I will see you guys, and make sure you leave me a comment down below on what you want me to do next. So I will see you guys in the next video.